Ah, it feels good to have dry feet. I do need to get some food inside me now. That is becoming very evident. I can feel my mood starting to go down, but somehow this fire has just lifted me. In the morning, I can put on toasty, warm socks.
It's dead. I do not like killing animals at all. My heart is absolutely racing, but that was too much of an opportunity to be missed. I'm thinking how I'm going to process this goat and make the best use of it.
Every single bit of this animal is going to go to good use.
It's imperative I get this hide off in one piece, because this is invaluable to me up at altitude. This is another layer of clothing. This is a warm blanket that's going to keep me from freezing up at 4,000 meters. It's going to give me an advantage over Josh. That is brilliant.
This brain, it's got loads of nutrients in it. And you can eat it raw. And it's actually really tender and good. But I can't eat it all because I need to use it to moisturize the hide. I'm gonna put bits of goat all over it so that I've got an even spread of moisturizing goat brain. Oh, it's going in nicely actually. The problem with hides, if you don't moisturise them, they'll just become as stiff as a board. It's a bit like polishing boot. The polish works into the leather and makes the leather more supple. And I can already feel the difference it's making. That's good. Okay. Only a matter of hours ago, this was on a living animal. It's incredible, isn't it, how you can kill an animal, skin it, and use part of the animal to actually make the hide more flexible, more malleable, more usable. You can see how I'm screwing that up, almost as if it's a piece of cloth. And to all intents and purposes, that is now my blanket for the mountains. I am very, very happy with that.
I'm just looking at the tracker at the moment. It's gone static. This could be for a number of reasons, but most likely he's consolidated in some way. Josh is catching up. He's now above 3,500 metres.
These berries are very good for altitude sickness. They taste slightly of wintergreen, so I'm assuming they're good for the lungs. I was struggling massively yesterday. It was just such an epic battle to get up the hill. My lungs are still gasping, but this is a huge advantage. These things are so tasty. And this lichen, this is an ancient Chinese herb. This is very, very expensive to buy. And it's very, very good for altitude sickness. You can eat it just as it is, but it's better to boil it up in a tea.
It's getting late in the day. I've got a pounding headache. I come up with a brilliant idea to have a nice cup of tea.
Oh yeah, there's so many different kinds of wild mint.
All of the mints all over the world have the same flower head. Some of them are bigger, some of them are smaller, but they've all got the same similarity. Oh man, that smells so good. I'm gonna pick a whole bunch of this, chuck it in my tea.
So I'm gonna light a fire now.
This is the ember that I saved earlier from my last fire. I've been carrying it in this mushroom here. So carrying that ember has saved me a ton of time and a ton of energy. Clay provides a barrier that water cannot penetrate. So I'm just gonna build a little puddle, fill the puddle up with water, heat some rocks up, put the rocks in the puddle, and then I'm gonna have a cup of tea. And I'm hoping it's gonna alleviate the symptoms that I'm feeling right now.
I'm gonna dump the chaga mushroom in, and I'm gonna put some of those herbs that I found in as well. The chaga helps the blood absorb the oxygen from the lungs. So that's my main problem out there. Because the air is so thin and there's so little oxygen, I'm really struggling to get that oxygen into my blood and through my body where I need it most. So fingers crossed this is gonna help. I do have this awesome bamboo straw that I whittled up. Oh, that's actually really good. Oh, yes.
I think I'm gonna make kebabs for supper. Kidney, heart, liver, eyeball kebab. The density of the nutrients in this type of meat is extraordinary. It's packed with iron. The nice thing about iron is that it enables the body to absorb more oxygen, so it should enable me to combat altitude sickness. And then the meat, which I know that I can cure, I can then make into jerky. I'm just making a very basic drying rack. It's just a pyramid with a triangle lashed on, which make it nice and strong. And it's gonna have slats across it where I'm hanging the strips of meat. I'm using smoke to carbonize the outside of the meat, and it will essentially cure the meat to be able to carry with me, and I can have a snack that I can eat on the move. I'm just gonna see what I can do with the intestines. I can make cordage out of this because I'm really struggling to get decent cordage around here. Okay, what we're gonna try and do now that I'm beginning to get individual strands is just squeeze all the excrement out. Right, I've got crap all over my hands. That's good. Yuck. Just had a bit of an eruption. This is taking me back to nappy changing days. Oh, there's poo everywhere. There is poo everywhere. That is now a very, very valuable resource to me. That's cordage, or it will be by the time I've dried it out. Consolidation is always something that is hard to make yourself do when you're in a race scenario. But I know from experience that if I just keep going, then I don't have enough energy at the end. But with this amount of food inside me, I'll get stronger and stronger and faster and faster. I think that that eyeball, that first eyeball, is ready to eat. It tastes good. The amount of nutrients in that eyeball and that bit of tongue is massive. I'm now in a very, very good position. Today could not have gone any better as far as I'm concerned. I managed to find a goat, kill it, process that animal to get every single last resource out of it. I've got biltong to take up into the mountains to feed on, a warm hide that I can actually stay comfortable under when it gets really, really cold at night. And I'm making a pack frame to carry it all. I have no idea where Josh is. Fingers crossed, behind me.